Alrighty, welcome to round two. Would like to play first? Here we go. Here's the skipper. This is exactly the kind of hand you want because it has turn on either vial and a bunch of merfolk. Turn on either vial on the play with all merfolk. Yeah, I would say you're a favorite against almost everything, but obviously now my opponent's gonna play turn on amulet, turn two summer bloom, and easily defeat me. But hey, so. My turn two play is just going to be Silver Gill Adept, I would assume. Ooh, I like seeing Cataxian Probe because that helps the odds I'm playing against like a Grixis type deck. And this hand is quite good against Grixis. Vial just makes it so their counter spells don't do anything, and you just get to play a bunch of Merfolk at a pretty fast clip. And Silver Gill Adept is a good card advantage. It is true that this hand is potentially vulnerable to Bolt, Snapcaster, Bolt, but. If I draw no more lands this game, I'm going to win it very easily. And Steam Vents or a Watery Grave? No, Island. Basic Island and Aseer Visions. And open to Hard Cask Cataxian Probe. Could be playing against a Storm deck, I suppose, but the second probe, a little less alluring there. Alright, let's cast this. Reveal Lord of Atlantis. Pass the turn. Vial. Not the worst. Let us go ahead and ramp file to two land. Oh, the question is, do I want to play Reverie and run into Remand or Mana Leak? Kind of don't. I'm just gonna play an Aether Vial. I feel like getting Remanded or Mana Leaked would be pretty unfortunate. And I actually think I don't Vial in Lord here to play around Lightning Bolt. Basically, if I just wait on the Vialing in the Lord, my opponent either has to Bolt Silver Gill Adept or not use the mana. And I like the advantage of doing nothing and forcing the Bolt on Silver Gill Adept. There we go. And I would have done the same amount of damage had I Vialed in Lord and my opponent bolted it, so I'm happy enough. Alright, so I'm definitely Vialing in Lord end of turn. I would assume that's better than Vialing in Harbinger. And probably gonna get Snapcaster bolted here. So you're getting an Island? No, we're getting a Watery Grave. Alright, so we're playing against Grixis, so I don't have to worry too much about like a Splinter Dune. I guess I could be playing against Grixis Twin, but I think the probes make it more likely they're playing Delver. Oh, Cologne's Command. Sure. And discarding. Killing the Vial. Oh, that's pretty good. Land. Ooh, Kira's. Kira's great. Once you resolve Kira, it kind of makes all your problems go away. Or, at the very least, it makes it so your opponent has to spend a lot of effort on killing it. Alright, here comes a Tassigar or a Gurmag Angler. Vial up to two. Could Vial in Silver Gill Adept. This sounds pretty good. And draw Cavern of Souls. That'd be kind of perfect. A Master of the Pearl Trident. Alright, let's just attack with Kira. I don't really want to get remanded, but now I have too many things to play, so now I'm going to play Marrow, Reverie, and get remanded. Or Mana Leaked, whatever. I'm not, because I don't have the two vials anymore, I only have the one, and because my opponent could kill a vial, seems like I could run into problems here. Opponent can't even profitably attack, or at least if they do, Harbinger is going to come get them. So, alright. Don't want to vial in anything. I only have the one vial, so I have to decide whether I want to ramp it to three or not. I think I do. I could ramp it to three. There's a lot of things I could do. I could play another Mana Leak. Kolaghan's Command is kind of annoying, but I guess they would have killed the Vial already. Basically, I could ramp it to three, Vial in Reverie, then play Harbinger, target the Angler, and if my opponent has a counterspell, yeah, let's just do that. I could also just draw a land. Spreading Seas is a little less impressive. Well, I am actually going to cast Spreading Seas, though. I'm going to cast it on the Sulphur Falls. If my opponent has a counter, now they have to cast it. And, well, they don't have to cast it, rather. They could easily not. If they have a red spell, is what I meant, they have to cast it. And if I draw a land off this, I can use my plan. Alright, so this makes me glad I did not go with the other plan. So now let's just attack for two and pass the turn. Alright. And opponent's on not lots of lives. And can play like a Snapcaster in a turn or a Bolt in a turn. Neither of those really do much. Thought Scour, I suppose? Or he's running out the Snappy. The Snap Father. Alright. If I draw Cavern, obviously I'm in incredible shape. Alright. I'm going to take my 5 here. Vile. Yes. Put Reedery into play. Now I can play 2 Merfolk. I mean, I could have last turn, but I want to try to play around counter spells. All right, let's not move Vile to 4. Ooh, Curse Catcher. That's a good one to start with. So play Curse Catcher, untap my island. Not worried about a removal and Reedery because I have Kira in play. This makes countering a little more difficult for my opponent. Mana leaking the Curse Catcher. All right. Let's play Master of the Pearl Trident. Also untap an island. And did not get spell snared. Let's cast this and tap the Snapcaster Mage. Alright, and that should be game. Because I'm going to get to bounce the Angler too, so I definitely won't like Kira in this matchup. Relic of Progenitus I've actually found to be useful as well. What do I not like? Again, I kind of don't like Reedery, just the more expensive cards. Actually, Spreading Seas is still the worst. Playing against the blue decks, yes, you can Spreading Seas and kind of get them, but honestly, I don't love doing that, and I'd rather just have like a nice remand in. Though Spell Pierce also pretty good against Kolaghan's Command and Cryptic Command. So maybe I have 2 Spell Pierce, 2 remand, and I take out the Reedery's just because, well, I don't want to take out all of them. Don't want to have too many non-creature spells here. Well, let's just put in the 1 Spell Pierce, I suppose. Alright, this hand is pretty bad. I think I keep it just because my opponent mulligan and I don't really want to mulligan. You know, 3 good spells and 4 lands, even though 4 lands is like 2 more than I often will want. Well, now it's getting bad. If I knew my top card was an island, I would probably mulligan. Mutavault's kind of nice. Let's see what my opponent kept. Let's see, both cards. Huh. That makes me less inclined to want to play something, but I don't know if I'm supposed to just not. I kind of don't want to play anything though. I'm actually going to play this because the odds that my opponent has a bunch of counter spells in their deck are lower, higher now that my opponent's sacrificing Watery Grave, but. Generally, I think you're supposed to side out mana leaks against Merfolk, though maybe on the play you want them. Maybe I shouldn't assume that my opponent is doing that, even though I generally like doing that. Alright. And now I'm getting Anglered. Or I'm not. Alright, well I'm not going to play the Master yet. Or Lord. I'm just going to play land and pass the turn. Leave remand up, and the next turn I can play my Merfolk. Obviously, it's very suspicious that I don't play anything here. Opponent's Thought Scoured away, Snapcaster, and a bunch of Thought Scours. Alright, opponent's land go. Land, play the Master that my opponent knows about. I'm losing this game pretty badly. Just because I have 7 lands total, and that's a lot more. If my opponent plays a Cryptic Command here, probably just going to remand my own Master. Got to play for the long game. Remanding Cryptic's a lot less appealing, I think. I'm not killing my opponent anytime soon here, so this seems a lot better. Oh, well, Master Waves is good. That's one of the kind of cards that can get me into this. Probably next turn play Lord of Atlantis and Master of the Pearl Trident or some combination of them. Opponent gets to paving the life to Gitaxian Probe. Makes me very suspicious of a Cryptic Command here. Land go. Interesting. Dismember's not horrendous. Alright, let's play a land. just in case my opponent has Mana Leak or Snapcaster Mana Leak. And if they let this resolve, I'm not playing another spell here. I think I will attack with Mutavault though. My opponent doesn't actually have anything that's that great to Snapcaster. And I have a hidden Dismember, if that's relevant. Opponent could now command my Master of the Pearl Trident, which is unfortunate. Strong. Maybe Spell Pierce is great. Grixis runs on a light, low land count. Interesting. If or when we go to game three, I'll have to ponder putting in Spell Pierces here. Well, otherwise, I'm fairly happy with how this is going. I mean, I think my Master of the Pearl Trident's getting terminated. Well, that's a lot less bad for me than commanded. Alright. I'm slowly grinding my opponent out. I can't really afford to draw too many more lands here. Let's play Minamo. Just gonna play the Lord. This resolves also, so my opponent could Snapcaster and terminate here. And then I guess I probably just dismember the Snapcaster. I mean, I could have just not attacked. That certainly was an answer. Oh, my opponent went to block and can't because of Island Walk. All right, well, jackpot. Yeah, that was unfortunate. So now my opponent has to terminate the Lord of Atlantis and still take 2 damage. All right, well, I guess that worked out kind of optimally. Pass the turn. Opponent knows about Master of Waves, does not know about Marrow Reedry. Only has 2 cards in hand. If they're on all terminates, Master of Waves could be a very big problem. I would love to draw another way to, like, another counterspell just to stop Master from getting Cryptic'd. But I don't know if I have an option to do that. So my opponent just passes. I don't think I dismember there. Alright, let's play Marrow Reedry. See if my opponent has a Cryptic command. If they do Cryptic, I'm probably going to go Master of the Pearl Trident, attack you for 3. If they don't Cryptic, I'm going to go Master of the Pearl Trident, tap your Snapcaster Mage. I can get Mana Leaked here, but I still will have a 3-3 Mutavault. Also, if my opponent goes Snapcaster Mana Leak, it's not the end of the world either. Alright, looks like Kolaghan's Command. Killing my Reedry and getting back. No, Snapcaster, no, making me discard. Alright, I'll discard Dismember. Yeah, let's tap that. Smash my opponent for 3 down to 5. And then keep. I think Master Always is better than Dismember here. Yes, my opponent could play a Gurmag Angler, but I think Master of Waves. I suppose Master of Waves is better, but if my opponent kills Master of the Pearl Trident, we're kind of back to it not being great. Opponent kept one of the cards off Seer Visions. And let's see. Ooh, Remand has to be good. Let's play Master of Waves. My opponent has Cryptic Command. Now I'm remanding the Cryptic, and I assume that basically wins me the game. I guess it doesn't literally win me the game, but it's pretty good. Alright. Ooh, I left Mutavault up because it would let me. I guess I don't attack the Master Pearl Trident. Because if I drew any land, I could. I was supposed to return Oboro. The one time it would be useful. I mean, it'll be fine because I'll still get to Spell Pierce on my turn, but I left Mutavault up because clearly if I draw a land, I want to hit with my 4-4 Island Walking Mutavault, but drawing the Spell Pierce is going to be pretty good, I would assume. Because now I get to animate Mutavault. My opponent's going to try to Cryptic, and then I just win the game. They can block the Master and the, well, Master, and then I get to hit them for 10. Or they block Mutavault, Master of Waves, and take 8. And that will do it. So the Snapcaster, not getting to block the Mutavault that one turn, ended up being kind of the game. And I should have brought in more Spell Pierces. Alright, well, lesson learned. I'm deciding what to cast Cryptic on, but has no idea that it doesn't matter. I'm gonna get to Cryptic or Spell Pierce no matter what happens here. So it feels kind of bad for my opponent that they have to decipher what the best Cryptic command target is, not knowing it's ultimately irrelevant, but I mean, it's good practice still for them. You should make the optimal play, even though in this case it doesn't matter. And that should be game. Get to attack with everything, and GG's. Oh, all right, on to round three. Mm-hmm.